In the news tonight, churches in Benin hold special service to mark this year's Father's Day. Just as the state governor lauds the role of fathers, especially in the fight against COVID-19. A very good evening to you. Many thanks for joining us on NTA Benin News. Main news, I am Obehiu Tubaprasai, and this news has been streamed live from Benin City, Edo State, Nigeria. Christians in Benin City today joined their counterparts across the globe to celebrate the sacrifice of fathers in building godly homes, as well as their contributions to the development of churches and the society. Judah Bugu monitored the celebration in Benin Metropolis and now reports.
These are some of the special features that characterize the Father's Day celebration in churches visited in Benin City. Other features that added color to Father's Day celebration in the churches include an all-fathers choir, altar servant, and ushering, all officiated and supervised by fathers, as well as special numbers and presentations. The day, among other things, also seeks for a renewal to duties as heads of homes and leaders in society.
As a man, you are the head of your house. You are the physical head of the house. You are the spiritual head of the house. You must be able to pray, seek coverage, spiritual coverage for your family.
We are looking at the life of Joseph as a father who laid his life for the family. So that's why we're encouraging our fathers to also do the same.
I'm proud of myself being a father, one. I really thank God that spread my life to see another Father's Day celebration. I think I'm glad.
We are celebrating them. That's why both men, women in the church today, we are all in happy mood. Some couples are even wearing a coat to celebrate together as a family.
From churches to homes and recreational centers for the celebration. Recreational centers such as this Oba Zoo did not, however, witness influx of visitors to celebrate the day, as we were made to understand that most churches in the state have special events for Father's Day celebration. In one of such events, organized by the St. Paul's Catholic Church, GRA, fathers were treated to a lavish reception. Obehi, what do you wish fathers like me on this special day?
Well, Jude, I certainly wish all fathers out there a very happy Father's Day. And moving on, Governor Godwin Obaseki has hailed the sacrifice and resilience of fathers amid COVID-19 crisis in celebrating fathers for their immense role in holding the family units together despite disruptions caused by the coronavirus pandemic and the attendant dislocation in economies across the world. His decision to keep the economy of the state during the pandemic is an acknowledgement of the need to provide a lifeline for the survival of families, as his administration is aware of the enormous responsibilities required to sustain families during a global pandemic. According to the governor, the state is working assiduously to ensure that it provides a conducive business environment that guarantees the survival and growth of businesses. The governor further says he is pursuing very pragmatic policies to open up the economy so that fathers would be actively engaged and be able to deliver on their duties on the home front. And customarily, the responsibility of serving as a mass server at the Catholic Mass falls in the hands of pubescent adult altar boys. Sometimes it is scaled up a bit and parish seminarians are employed in the role. But occasionally the extraordinary happens, as when a layperson and minister of considerable age dons the colors of a mass server at the same celebration. An event like this is a privileged experience and is therefore memorable. Deputy Governor Philip Shaibu has been honored with this privileged chance to again serve at the Lord's holy altar. This occurred during a mass to celebrate Father's Day at the St. Paul's Catholic Church here in Benin. Elizabeth Omoko, who was at the Holy Mass, takes up the story from here. Please.
Catholics treasure every part of the Mass, right from the introductory rites, the liturgy of the word, the liturgy of the Eucharist, to the concluding rites and other liturgical seasons which commemorate salvation history. These are celebrated or co-celebrated by the bishop, priest, seminarian, as the case may be. And to help preserve this sacred tradition are the altar boys. The service is a serious responsibility at any Mass, and the community is grateful for the sacrifices of their own time and talents. It is therefore the well-behaved manner of the Deputy Governor in the church and society, and his ability to follow set rules that has conferred this great honor and privilege on him to serve at the Lord's altar as an extraordinary minister. Many describe the Deputy Governor as an epitome of humility.
He has ever shown himself that he's the Alpha and Omega. He always shows himself as a servant to the call, a servant to the people.
Earlier at the Mass to celebrate Father's Day, with the theme on Hard Joseph, a role model to fatherhood, parish priest Reverend Father Edwin Omorogbe called on the fathers to shun activities capable of destroying the family and the society in general. The men took over every activity of the day. The Deputy Governor says the role he played reminds him of the old days. He wants fathers and all heads in the helm of affairs to use their positions to bring development to every facet of their lives.
As father, we are the head of the family. Our utterances at home, we're shaping our family. Our utterances at home, we determine whether our children will be positive or negative. If we are negative at home, in all our utterances, just know that we are building a generation of young ones that the utterances will be negative. So the starting point is our home.
Others, including the wife of the Deputy Governor, wants women to always magnify their husbands at all times.
Come to realize that when a man makes a mistake, the wife celebrates the mistake. But when he does something good, she keeps it to herself because she doesn't want to share that good thing that he has done for her. So that's the advice I'll give to women. Magnify your husband's good qualities and try to reduce talking about his bad sides.
One of our fathers in St. Paul, we have made it a tradition that on a day like this, we offer service to our wives and our children. So that is why we chose this year St. Joseph, a role model to fatherhood. So
the day climaxed with a reception in honor of all men in the church, the state, and the nation in general. Omoko, NTN News.
Father is believed to be that male figure in the family unit whose role is to nurture the pillar of support for his children, wife, and the entire household. As Nigeria joins other nations to celebrate fathers, Ifeoma Okafor takes a look at the history and significance of Father's Day celebration.
Father's Day was created by a woman named Sonora Smart Doss to honor her father's effort in raising her and her five siblings. Doss wanted to establish a day just like Mother's Day to appreciate her father. The first official Father's Day was celebrated on June 18, 1972. Since then, the day that falls in third Sunday of June is celebrated a Father's Day each year. And so this year's Father's Day 2021 falls on June 20. Father's Day is a holiday of honoring fatherhood and paternal bonds, as well as the influence of fathers in society. For these respondents, fathers are special and should be acknowledged.
To be a father, you must be prepared to labor and to persevere. You must be prepared also to guide in love and to forgive. Forgive truly.
They are the head of the home. God has given them the key to be the head of the home. Right, we are at the bottom. So they are worth celebrating.
When you look at the prize and the sacrifices that fathers make, they deserve to be celebrated. And when you celebrate someone for what he's doing, his morale is boosted to do more.
God, my father nurtured me very well. Although he was a peasant farmer, but he did well for all his children. So we emulate from him.
Continue to keep our fathers for us. They will continue to be what God has made them to be in their various homes. And we children, we should also take care of our fathers.
They enjoined family and society to honor fathers as the backbone of every family. In Benin, Ifeoma Okafor, NTA News.
Let's take a break. More reports in a moment. Stay with us.
For center of Benin, Iyeme, Agun Berekete for everybody.
Waiting, your body to the heart.
This one cool me for body. Oh, Agun Bonanza to travel to different place for Nigeria. Muyi line your Tramodden office for Ibiwe by Ebo Street Junction. Ring Road for Benin City. Don't make travel easy for Tinkele money for everybody. Benin to Warri, 1,000 Naira. Benin to Port Harcourt, 3,500 Naira. Benin to Lagos, Maitu, Yanokwaja, Iyaba, Aja for just 3,500 Naira. Benin to Aujiekuma, 1,000. Enjoy unbeatable price to Bayasa, Abraka, Ugele, and other places, including comfortable charter service to any destination. Muyi Parcel Service, they give that to help you receive parcel and send parcel to different places for Nigeria. Come enjoy Ogbele Awoof Travel Price with brand new buses and cars for Muyi Line New Ultra Modern Office for Ibiwe Street, Baebo Street Junction, Ring Road, Benin City. Muyi Line, cheap travel price for everybody.
Next time you visit the ancient city of Benin, two things will excite you. The warmth and welcome of its people, and of course, the class and style of its hospitality business. Rendeki Gold, home of hospitality like no other, located in one of the most serene environments in the ancient city, truly classy and exquisite with world-class facilities. Fully equipped digital multi-purpose hall with life-size ultra-high definition LED screen, 180 square meters king-size swimming pool with bubble bath, enough to leave you breathless. The exotic Ariel's Bistro and Grill restaurant with variety of continental dishes, especially some of the rarest delicacies you can find in town. Fact is, a visit will truly convince you that we are gold. Rendeki Gold is the gold wing of the prestigious Rendeki Royal Hotel at 6 Uhenuyi Street off Ihama and Boundary Roads, GRA Benin City, www.rendekihotels.com. Rendeki Gold, our hospitality is gold.
Oh yes, eh. Ameosa Motors. We don't stand up for we new branching for number 128 Saple Road by Ajib Junction for Benin City. Not be only that one, oh. We don't upwekerize the price for Niger Delta Roads. We need to worry by NRA Junction 500. We need to Abraka 700. We need to Ugeli 1000. We need to Bayasa 1500. We still a load from Benin to Port Harcourt. Worry to Auchi, worry to Ekpoma, Benin to Ekun, Obiaruko, Kwale, Umutu, even Ekpoma to Port Harcourt City. For Ameosa Motors, safety of all our passengers, now it be number one. That's now why we make sure, say, we use new motors and qualified drivers. Make you visit any of our branches around you to enjoy the upwekerization of Ameosa Motors. Ameosa Motors, king of the road.
Experience a touch of class and wonderful hospitality at Millennium Grand Hotel, Benin City. From our wide range of rare stock wines and other drinks and food services, you can make your choice of taste from our varieties. Our bedrooms are exquisitely furnished to match your taste and provide you comfort. For your next conference, the Millennium Grand Hotels is your best bet with its roomy space and updated facilities. Come try out our gazebos and the swimming pool, your ideal pick of where to relax. Try out a new and better experience in hospitality, Millennium Grand Hotel, and you will be the first to tell many others. It's a special experience. Millennium Grand Hotel, number 167 Sapele Road, Benin City. For bookings and reservations, call 091-301-21020 plus these other numbers on your screen or millenniumgrandhotel@gmail.com. You will find us at Zenit Experience.
Many thanks for staying with us. The sermon in churches visited this Sunday harped on the importance of good fatherhood, praises and worship. Joy Egbo reports.
At St. Paul's Catholic Church, Very Reverend Father Edwin Omoregbe urged children to love their parents and demonstrate equal love to them.
I don't know the crisis that you may be facing. I don't know the storm you may be facing. The Lord, through Job, speaks to you, thus far, an end to your tragedy.
At United Baptist Church, Reverend Oswalele, who took his test from Luke chapter 15, used the story of the prodigal son who returned home and was welcomed by his father, harped on the need for fathers to have a forgiving heart and be alive to their responsibility.
There is nothing that we desire that this father will not give unto us when we love him and come to him. And so the son said, I will go to my father. He has everything. And when I get to where he is, that's the repentant heart.
Pastor Victor Osakpolo of the Victory Way Church International told the congregation to always pray and praise, being the two weapons that are needed in life to overcome challenges.
Why are they going to praise God? Why they were haunted? Chains were on their legs. Their hands were fasting with chains. But why they were in that
Meanwhile, at God's Gift Church of Jesus Christ, prophetess Patience Azeta prayed for fathers as they celebrate on that day. She prayed that the blessings of God will not depart from them and wished them well.
Even a day born of a late child is already a father. We pray that tomorrow they will be father. We look forward for them. May the will of God be done in the life of the fathers.
In Benin, Joy Igbo, NTA News.
The General Overseer of Christ Tower Ministries, Reverend Jacob Igbo, in a sermon titled A Noble Father, wants fathers to live up to their expectations so as to attract the blessings of God. This was a submission at the church service held in honor of fathers at the headquarters in Benin City. Judah Bugu has details.
Reverend Igbo, who took the Bible test from the book of Genesis chapter 2 verse 18 and Proverbs 31 verse 31, told the congregation that a noble father is the one that cares for his family. He added that a responsible father will not go outside his wedlock, rather rebrands his family to suit his taste and for the purpose God created a family.
You must be a father that respects your wife. And a father that care for the children. Mothers are helpmates. They help you to keep the home. But some fathers leave the responsibility of the family for the mother. Which means you have deviated from the plans of God. A man that is not able to take care or fight for the family is worse than infidel. Be up to your responsibility so that your position can be duly respected.
He advised men not to abandon their wives in order not to crash land. In Benin, Jude Abugu, NTA News.
And the spiritual leader of Deliverance Holy Mission International, Professor Sunday Okpere, in his sermon titled Breaking Hard Ground, Season 5, wants Christian leaders not to take the propagation of the gospel of Christ as mere whistleblowing, but to ensure unity among the body of Christ. This was the cross of the message delivered by the spiritual leader at the church headquarters in Benin City. Joy Ebo reports.
Prophet Sunday Okpere sell the fivefold ministry as assigned by Jesus Christ in Ephesians chapter 4, verse 11 to 16, wants Christians to appreciate each other rather than seeking the downfall of fellow brother to attain higher position. He added that pastors fight pastors for their personal interest and enjoins them to desist as it leads to condemnation. The spiritual leader advised the congregation to respect pastors, prophets, evangelists, and teachers of the gospel of Jesus Christ.
I want to say here that you should not propagate the gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ in their whistleblowing. Don't stop at whistleblowing from hearing your voice or in a written language, but focus and assure the unity of the body of Christ. It pains me to note that so many of our brethren will come out to say, I'm a man of God, but you don't believe in your own man of God. If you are a prophet, treasure the evangelist. If you are an evangelist, treasure the pastor. But pastor today, because of their oration, is not arguing, quoting the activities and the gift of the prophet. Why? Because of self-recognition. Why the identity crisis among the body of Christ, now called the body of Christ? The world is looking up to you. We have to retrieve our system and fight to ensure this unity.
Meanwhile, One Day Revival program with team Tribune Will Rise Again is slated to hold on the 27th of June at Enya branch of the church in Benin City. The spiritual leader made prophetic declaration for peace in Edo State and Nigeria. In Benin, Joy Egbo, NTA News.
And Christians have been enjoined to be careful of friends and family members they interact with, as the majority of them have evil intentions. This was the advice of the spiritual leader of Christ Chosen Church of God International, Monsignor Apostle David Onuefe, at the Church Home Motel branch of the church in Benin City. Dennis Temple reports.
Monsignor Apostle David Onuefe said a lot of people, including notable men of God, are waiting for Satan to acquire wealth instead of Jesus Christ, who redeemed man from sin. He added that the truth has been buried in the name of money to attain high position, which will not enhance their souls. Apostle David Onuefe enjoined the congregation to live for Christ, the only hope of salvation.
Many are decamping from Jesus to Satan the devil. Do you not know that Satan is the prince of this world? And the devil too have his own manifesto or platform. Again, manifesto, as Jesus also have his platform. So that will say, follow me, I give you all things. Jesus too was tempted by the devil. After 40 days fasting, don't allow people to deceive you, to make you sell your God's given birthright, to sell your salvation.
Meanwhile, the spiritual leader of the church, Monsignor Davis Onuefe, celebrated his birthday in attendance where the minister of God and family members. In Benin, Dennis Temple, NTA News.
And the presiding priest of Holy Arosa Cathedral, Onsa Edebi, has enjoined worshippers to always depend on God for protection and provision of their needs. Onsa Edebi gave the charge in a sermon titled God Raised the King in Mix of Difficulties at the Cathedral Service in Benin City. Philomena Gwebo reports.
The Benin Foremost Church, Onsa Igbinogo Dua Edebi, said those who put their trust in men will be disappointed, for men can never be kind and merciful like Almighty God. He pointed out that the wickedness of man's heart is enough to prevent the existence of his fellow being if men were God. The Benin National Church of God High Priest urged worshippers to be thankful to God for the gift of life, adding that those who persevere in trials and temptations will wear the crown of glory. Prayers were offered for the well-being of the worshippers and for peace to reign in the country. In Benin, Philomena Ogbebo, NTA News.
Let's take a short break. We'll return the concluding segment of the news.
Let's celebrate as the Ojiro of Irua and Okaijisa of Isalan, His Royal Highness Aliagye W. Momodu II, JPCON, is 50 years on the throne. This celebration begins on Monday 21st to Sunday 27th June. Anniversary lectures, the Youth Carnival Award of Chieftaincy Titles and Certificate of Honours to Distinguished People, among others, will take place. Saturday 26th June, Grand Finale Day, Special Guest of Honour, Mr. Godwin Obaseki, Edo State Governor. Royal Father of the Day, His Royal Majesty Oba Ewuahie II, the Oba of Benin. Chairman, Senator Clifford Odia, who represent Edo Central at the National Assembly. Guests of Honor are His Excellency Goodluck Jonathan, GCFR, GCON, Right Honorable Philip Schwaibo, Edo State Deputy Governor, Right Honorable Marcus Honorable Speaker, Edo State House Assembly, His Excellency Sir Chief Gabriel Igbenedion, the Esama of Benin, Professor Sonny Abel Eromoseli, Proprietor of Mudiame University, is the Chief Host. For details, call 080-3381-5788. Planning Committee announced.
Remembering one's birthday usually comes with joy. The joy and ecstasy most times becomes deeper, especially as the number of years increase for Dame Iriagbose Joy Ozame, who's attaining the age of 60, which is no small feat. And this calls for celebration of her birthday. It took place in Benin. Ifeoma Okafor captured the event.
It was a show of class, beauty and style at the birthday celebration of Dame Iriagbose Ozame. The gracious entrance of the celebrant to the arena set the tone for the day.
She keep praying, and I keep offending her. I keep paying all the price. But one thing in my offense, I say, ah, the worst one is that will I win? Immunis or no? Even I use the word immunis, just for to pay.
That was the husband of the celebrant, Senator Ehigie Ozame, going down memory lane in capturing their good moments. The guests who came from far and near to grace the occasion were treated to sumptuous meals. Then the icing on the cake was when the celebrant caught her birthday cake. 60!
That must say is a role model to women who perhaps think they are looking for somebody who has millions of naira or whose father had money or have so much money, looking for women or a man whose father is rich. Ours was not like that.
She's a very easygoing person, a loving person. She holds no grudges against anybody.
Everything we want, she always does, and she's always there for us. Not just for us, the immediate family, also for extended family and also friends.
We look up to her in everything that we do. She's been a big inspiration and influence on all our lives.
For the celebrant, the secret of her longevity lies on these virtues.
Just be happy. Age is a thing of the mind. I know that my life has always been a building block because of the way God has always intervened in my affairs.
Prayers came in torrents for the celebrants.
We pray to God that she will celebrate very many more years, you know, in excellent health.
Prayer is that she will live to 70, 80, 90, 100 and become a centurion.
Live long to enjoy or to get reap the benefit of all she has sowed.
We pray the Lord to grant her more years in the service and also for her to serve humanity and serve her family many more years.
We celebrate her as she celebrates 60 years. That's a beautiful age to celebrate.
The celebrant, Dame Iriagbonse Joy Uzame Ni Iroha, was born on 15th of June 1961 in Benin City. Married to Senator Ehige Uzame, Dame Iriagbonse is a member of several organizations, which include Science Association of Nigeria, Mathematics Association of Nigeria, Women's Guild, and Mothers Union in the Anglican Communion, among others. In Benin, Ifeoma Okafor, NTA News.
And that's it on our main news tonight. Thank you very much for watching. Good evening.